Hey guys, welcome back to GGBDYT. And in this video, I know I'm really late, and well, I know this video is like after like 2 to 3 months of wait, but well, now we're here. So in this video, we will be making microchips, but without logic. The microchips will be the 8x microchips. Like, it's just a stepping stone to get like these things, the advanced logic things. You just need to sell one of the 8x microchips to get all of these things. So well, we'll be doing that and selling the 8x microchips. So as you can see, that's the logic assembler behind, and well, that will be used in the second part of the video, second part of the series, this microchip series. As you can see, it's really complex, but well, we don't have to do this today. Today we'll be making the 8x microchips using the logic, this assembler, precision assembler, this. And well, the recipe is as same, is the same that we'll be using in the next part, in which we'll be making the microchips using the logic. So here we have the logic plate, we have the copper plate, we have the semiconductors, and we have the gold wire. All of these things are a little hard to make except the copper wire. So we are gonna make these four things, and well, this video will be divided into like five parts, in which in the first part we'll be making the logic plates, second part will be copper wire, and third part will be semiconductor, and fourth part, which is the hardest part, will be the gold wire. And by the way, if the second part of this video is already uploaded, you need to watch this video. You need to make these four things in order to make the microchips using the logic. So yeah, first we are gonna make 8x microchips using the precision assembler, which doesn't require any logic. So yeah, so now let's start on making logic plates. So for making logic plates, you need silicon, you need plastic pellets, and you need copper plate. These two this one thing, the plastic pellets are a little hard to get. I mean, not little, but it's required. It's a little hard, and you need to make, and the silicon, you need coal and sand for that, and plastic pellets is a whole new thing to make. There's another tutorial on my channel for that. You need to watch that. It's in the description. So, well, let's first make silicon. So, first, to make the logic plates, you need the precision assembler. So I'm just gonna like place this where the plastic pellets is near. And if you don't know, if you haven't watched my lithium battery packs video, this is the pipeline I made for the plastic pellets. It's coming from the other side of my world. As you can see, it's a really long pipeline. So we are just gonna use this. And yeah. So well, then let's just do that, and I'm just gonna transfer it like that. Oops, did I delete the pipeline of the rubber? So yeah, well, fix the pipeline, and as you can see, I made a junction here for transferring the plastic pellets from here to the precision assembler, which is right here. So let me just move it somewhere much easier here. And by the way, this requires a lot of power, so you like need to make another power source for making this whole microchip factory. So yeah. So now the pipelining is done. As you can see, it's coming from like this corner, and here it's going in. Now we need to make silicon. By the way, if you like playing Industrialist, make sure to like this video and subscribe to this channel, because I am right now making a lot of Industrialist content, and I know you want to watch it. So yeah. So now we need to make silicon. For making silicon, let me show you the recipe. Let's go to the recipes tab, and here, as you can see, it's a silicon. Is coal plus sand. You can get the sand from the sand excavator. It's easy. So yeah, the coal plus sand. So let me show you the sand excavator. It's just right here. Let's just search for that. Yeah, here it is, the sand excavator. It's a little expensive, but I know you'll be able to handle it. As you can see, so this just generates sand, and we need coal too. And let's see, sand, coal plus sand in blast furnace. Okay, so we need the blast furnace. Let's put a blast furnace here, right here. So the sand, yeah, here the coal will go, and here the sand will go. So now let's make a simple coal factory. So as you can see, I have made the coal simple coal factory, and just connected the pipelines all together, and now we need to the main part, we need to power it. Now let's look for power, and you know what, never mind, let's just use this. I don't want to make another steam turbine for this whole separate thing. You know what, I have to make another separate steam turbine for this. So you should make it too, so that you don't run out of power. So guys, finally I made the steam turbine, as you can see. So now let's just connect everything like that. And well, by the way, the sand excavator requires a lot of power, so you need to give it a lot of power. And now we are making silicon. Nice. So now let's just do the pipeline again. Like, this is a whole lot of things. You need to make a whole lot of things here to make a whole lot of things. So well, this is a little really complex thing to make everything. So yeah, so now we have silicon here. Now we just need to make copper plates. If you don't know how to make copper plates, you just need the copper and like make it into plates, the copper ingots, and make it into plates. So yeah, I'm going to make that. So guys, now we have the copper plates. As you can see, it's a simple machine. So now we have done the pipeline, and now we are getting the coal plates, the copper plates into here. So now let's just power it and see the magic. We will get the logic plates, and well, this will require a lot of power, due to which I need to connect two more. Okay, I need another pole here. Let's attach it, and now we'll be getting the coal, I mean the logic plates, as you can see. That's it. So now that we have made the logic plates, now let's move on to the next part of making the copper wire. It's also very easy, so this will be a small part. So now to make the copper plates, the copper wires, you just need to like make the same machine, but you need to just add the roller. So yeah, let's make this machine again. So now we are finally making the copper wires. Well, we just made the whole machine back again. We made it right here and just put the copper plates into the roller, and we are now making the copper wire. Now our second requirement is done. Let's move on to the semiconductors part. So for making the semiconductors, let me just show you. The semiconductors are made from the silicon and from the aluminum ingots. And so what I'm gonna do is, I'm not gonna make another factory for the silicon. I'm just gonna use it from my this one and just get the aluminum ingots. Now I'm gonna let's see how to make aluminum ingots. So well, I got the aluminum ingots from far away, like from really far away, from the gold factory I made. So you need to watch the purple gold video to like make the aluminum ingots. So there's a timestamp there for the aluminum ingots, so yeah, you need to watch it. So here we got the aluminum ingots. Now let's see. So we need to just add aluminum ingot and wait, and now we need the silicon. So well, here we have the aluminum ingots, and there we have the silicon. The silicon is right here, so we need to mix all of that in the precision assembler again, and it's of 1 million. So you need 3 precision assemblers to be precise. So let's add it right here, and where will be the aluminum ingot holes. Okay. Yep, it will be a little hard to make this one. So now the pipelining is done, and we are now getting the aluminum ingots and silicon. As you can see, like, it's a really long pipeline. You need to watch the purple gold video in order to like make this aluminum ingots. So yeah, now let's provide power to this. Again, it will require a lot of power. Okay, yes. So now we'll be creating the semiconductors. Why are we not getting the semiconductors? Yeah. Okay, so here we have the semiconductors. Actually, the power was not sufficient, so you need to provide a lot of power for this. So you should make a diesel generator for this. I'm sorry, you need to create the diesel generator, not the steam turbine, because steam turbine is not able to provide much power to it. So that's the only reason. So now we are creating the semiconductors, and if you don't know, they are metalloids. There's something there of the metalloids category. Silicon is also a metalloid, and aluminium is a metal. So I don't know what the recipe is, how to make semiconductors, but here we have the semiconductors. So now the final step, which is the gold wire, is the hardest step too. So now let's make that. So now let's make the gold wire. As you can see, this is the gold factory. It's quite a big factory. So you need to watch the gold video for that, the first part of the video. Every link is in the description. You need to watch this in order to make the gold wires. So yeah, this is the gold ingots. Now you need to convert it into wires. For that, you just need this, the roller, which is in the first category, first tier. And well, this is really easy to make gold wires, but obviously it's very hard to make gold, but it's really easy to make gold wires. So yeah, something like that. And now let's just connect it with my pipeline. That, and now let's just power it. For powering it, obviously we'll be using this. And now we'll be getting the gold wires. Let's wait for it. Here we go, we got the gold wires. So now we just need to do pipeline and like transfer it all over there. So yeah, this will be hard, this will be painful. So finally we are getting the gold wires. This was a really long pipeline, as you can see. It's like going from here to here to here. It's one of the longest pipelines in my world, and it's really complex too. So well, you don't have to worry about the pipeline, at least in my world, because I've already done that. And obviously, if you are having trouble with pipelining, you just have to long press. You just have to hold your left mouse button, or like just touch on your mobile screen and just like, let me show you an example. Like that you can do the pipelines. So this makes it a whole lot of easier. So yeah, now we have the gold wires. Now we have everything we needed. Now let's finally make our 8x microchips. For that we obviously need the precision assembler. Oh, I got stuck in that. Okay, so here the logic plates will go, and here the semiconductors, no, the copper wire will go. And now where the copper wire is, okay, the copper wire is right here. We need to another painful pipelining. And the semiconductor is right here, and then the gold wire is right here. So yeah, now let's do another painful pipeline, because this is the final one, and then we will be creating the 8x microchips. So yeah, congrats. So yeah, let's do it. So after a really long pipelining session, as you can see, one of my most complex ones. Like, obviously it's not that complex, but still it's complex. But yeah, here you can see everything is in place. Now we just need to power it, and then we will be making the 8x microchips. So let's find a way to power it. So now we have powered it, and now we should be generating the 8x microchips. Let's wait for it. Like, as you can see, power is all up there. Let's see, it should be at any moment. Okay, why is it not producing it? Yep, everything is in place. Copper wire, logic plate, semiconductors, and gold wire. What? Oh yes, okay, now we are producing 8x microchip. Actually, it takes 30 seconds to produce it and requires a lot of power, but now we are producing it. Congrats guys, we are now producing 8x microchips. Now let's sell it. So I'm gonna sell it in a small truck depot, so that like we have money fast, like we don't have to like wait for money. We get money and like we just sell 10 of these microchips and then we get money. So yeah. So as you can see, now let's sell. By the way, these microchips sell for about $13,200 for one microchip. So well, I think this is not that worth it for the amount of work we had done, and obviously it already got sold out. So by the way, like, making this without logic, that isn't much worth it. So that is why I am going to recommend you to, like, not scrap this idea. You have to get all these materials, so you need to watch this video and you need to make these all of the gold wire, the copper logic plates, the semiconductors and the copper wire. You need all of these in order to make that from the logic assembler. As you can see, I have already done the setup, the circuit of it. The second part will be coming in a few weeks, because it takes up a lot of time to make up these kind of videos, because these takes a lot of time to make. So yeah, so guys, I hope you have enjoyed this video. Make sure to drop a like and make sure to subscribe to this channel if you like this content, if you like my content, and make sure to join my community server of Discord. Like, it's obviously its link is in the description. You have to join it, because if you don't join it, like, or if you are stuck, you can like ask the staff for help. So yeah, and by the way, I will be sharing a blueprint of how to make the microchips too. So yeah, thank you guys. Make sure to share this video also with your friends. So yeah.